Blackstone presents Janitors, School of Garbage by Tyler Whitesides. This book is read by Alex Boyles. For Doug. Chapter 1. It's just magic. Jump into the garbage, she'd said. It'll be fun, she'd said. Staring at the smelly dumpster behind the elementary school, Landon Murphy had a feeling that this was some elaborate prank to make him look stupid. But that didn't seem like Jade's style.
We're lucky, you know,
Jade said, wiping sweaty pink hair from her forehead. She tried to lean her bicycle against the wall of the school, but the front tire turned and it crashed to the ground, knocking Landon's down with it. Why are we lucky? Landon finally asked. It wasn't that he wanted to know the answer, but he knew that Jade wouldn't stop talking about it until he asked.
Because there are a lot of regular dumpsters in the world, Jade answered, but ours is magic.
She waved her hands through the air when she said the word, chipped fingernails shimmering with glittery paint. Okay, Landon said. He'd believe it when he saw the dumpster do something magical. Right now, it looked as plain as could be. Nasty stains streaked the tan metal. The black lid was flipped open, and a stench rose from the inside, trash baking in the afternoon sun. Jade skipped forward, the buckles on her overalls jingling. That girl skipped everywhere in her hand-painted rainbow sandals. She and Landon would both be in sixth grade this fall. Wasn't that a little too old to be skipping about so cheerfully? And what did she have to be so excited about anyway? Wasn't life just as messed up and confusing for her as it was for him?
Isn't this the most amazing thing in all the whole wide world?
She said, running one hand along the edge of the dirty dumpster. We must have different definitions of amazing, Landon said. Jade twitched her head to the side and muttered over her shoulder.
He doesn't get it yet, but he will.
She was a strange one, Jade Shu. She talked to her own shoulder more than she talked to anyone at school. Hanging around with her certainly wasn't going to do Landon any favors with the popular kids. But his mom was making him do it. 2 weeks into summer break, and Jade had finally convinced him to follow her to this magic dumpster.
Did you bring what I told you to bring?
She asked, lowering her voice as if sharing a dramatic mystery. Landon gestured toward the sack of garbage at his feet.
Good job, brother.
Jade pointed a thumb into the open dumpster.
Now get in there.
Get in there? Landon repeated skeptically.
I don't even know what I'm doing.
He cleared his throat and muttered the next part. And I'm not your brother.
You will be, she said cheerfully, in just 3 short weeks. My dad's almost done cleaning out your room.
3 weeks until Landon's mom married Jade's dad. 3 weeks until he moved in across the hall from this weirdo he had spent most of last year avoiding. Landon peered into the dumpster, ready to change the subject. Doesn't look like a magical portal to me. Jade had said it would lead somewhere spectacular, but it just looked gross. This was ridiculous. He shouldn't have come along.
Well, obs, Jade said. If it looked like a magic portal, people would think it was a magic portal. The trick is that it looks like a perfectly ordinary dumpster.
How do you find it?
Mr. Clarence.
The janitor? Landon glanced up at the school. In all his years at Stafford Elementary, he had never actually spoken to Mr. Clarence. If Landon had been seen talking to the janitor, Carlos and Xander would have made fun of him for sure. Landon squinted at the school, all closed up for the summer. He was happy to be graduated from that place. Middle school was going to be better. Right?
Mr. Clarence is the reason for all of this, Jade said. We've been friends since I was in third grade. You know my art wall?
No, Landon said quickly. Was she talking about that weird wall in her house that she kept painting and repainting?
Well, I have a glorious wall in my bedroom that my dad lets me decorate however I want, Jade said. In third grade, Mr. Clarence caught me picking milk cartons out of the trash for my wall of greatness.
Landon had no idea what milk cartons had to do with art.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.